Manchester. Here's Peter White.
I know that, dude.
Good morning, Peter. Good morning, Peter.
All right, everyone, let's do this. It's Friday morning. Good morning, Manchester. It is the morning show coming at you live from downtown Manchester at 95.3 FM WMNH. And we are ready to kick off your weekend. Get ready. All right, here we go. We got Darryl Dion in the house. Good morning, Darryl.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I love that voice, man. I love that voice.
I know, but it's not, Val is not loud this morning.
Good morning.
Like, what is going on?
I don't know.
Anyway, all right, kicking off the Friday. Let's do it. We got a big show for you today. We'll have Crissy Kantor from Chill Spa coming in at 8 o'clock. For, she's always given us good advice.
Oh, absolutely.
And we'll play a round of match game, Darryl.
We love it.
Oh, yes. Hey, it's Friday. Here he is, Eazy-G.
And the best news ever, my phone is back.
Okay.
All right.
Where did
your phone back?
Where did
I left it in Josh's car, and he was really nice to bring it back from Concord yesterday. So shout out to Josh.
Wow, what a haul. Way up north.
Yep, we didn't have to do that.
No, he didn't.
Because I was stupid to leave it in his car.
Yeah, you were very stupid there.
Yeah.
So how are you today, Eazy-G?
Feeling good, because I'll see Crissy Kantor tomorrow for the Relay for Life Fisher Cat game. Looking forward to that with 16.
How do you know she's going there? How do you know that?
Because she got us a ticket. The ticket is waiting for her at the box office tomorrow at 5:30.
All right, so she has to go to the game.
Well, she's going to have to go
in.
To the game.
She's locked in.
She's locked in to the Fisher Cats game tomorrow.
Jesse was going to go, I saw her the other day on Tuesday here at the Cubs with Jen.
Oh, really?
Excellent.
Yeah, she was here with Jen on Wednesday, right?
Yes. Then I'm going down to Chill Spa the following Saturday to see her get my toes cut.
So you're going to get...
You can never get enough of Chill, Crissy Kantor and Chill Spa.
That's right.
Absolutely.
And don't forget, if you want a, for all you AARP members, September 18th, free ice cream day over at Goldenrod Restaurant over there on Candia Road.
Thanks for bringing that up, Goldenrod Pete.
That's right. That's right.
We Golden Rod B.
Yes. Thank you so much. Eazy-G.
That's your new name, though.
I know. So, wow, what a day. It's 62 degrees in downtown Manchester right now. We got overcast skies, but once this goes through, you're going to see a little bit of sun at the end of the day. What's setting up to be the perfect summer weekend, Darryl?
Yes, I noticed the guys at the at Hampton Beach starting to create their artwork.
That's right, the sand sculptures.
Yeah, and they were saying that it's good. It's not a bad thing for it to rain. It helps moisten the sand.
Right. And it's together. Not, no, don't, you know, they ship in that sand also.
Oh, it's not beach sand.
It's not Hampton Beach sand.
No, and it rained yesterday, boy.
That's right. Thank you. Yes, it did sure rain.
Yeah.
Well, we're happy to have you, Darryl. Good luck to you.
Well, thank you very much.
Boy.
Yeah, speaking of shorts, I'm debuting my 2019 Relay for Life t-shirt.
Oh, where? Today? That's it right there?
Yep.
It looks like an old shirt.
And you have to raise $100 to get one, and I raised almost $300. So I could have asked technically.
Well, you actually raised $400, kept $100 for yourself, right. And turned it into
$300. Right.
Right. Yes.
Fatten up that bank account.
Yes. First and last month's rent.
Yeah, absolutely.
For the new place. How's the new place going, anyway?
Very well.
Really?
Good.
What's it like in there? Like, your first night sleeping there, and then you wake up in the morning, and you're like, wow, here I am in my new place.
Great, because I didn't have to wait in line to go to the bathroom. That's amazing.
Oh, man.
You have to wait in line to go to the bathroom?
No, the other place was always problems with the bathroom.
Really?
So 9 out of 10 times, the bathroom is available right around the corner.
Right, 9 out of 10 times. But
yeah, sometimes
you have
to
wait.
Go upstairs, but that's okay, because there's 2 bathrooms upstairs.
Right. I don't know if I get that. Do you wait in line for the bathroom at your place now?
I better not.
Right.
If I have to wait in line, there apparently is way too many folks in the house.
I don't like to wait in line.
No.
Not at all.
Nobody Although does. I've become more patient with that.
Really?
Because there's nothing you can do about it.
Good morning, Peter.
Well, there you go, Val. Thank you so much.
Oh, my God. Morning, Val.
Yeah, no kidding. What happened?
What is going
going on.
All right.
Good morning, Peter.
All right. Well, thank you, Val.
Well, before I lost my phone at the, I went to the Real Life LF wrap-up party on Wednesday, and I got this nice bag.
Well, listen, you got to talk into the microphone, first of all. You're all over the place.
I got this nice bag, and I got the, for having teen spirit, and I got another T-shirt.
Ooh.
Well, no one packing. Cares.
And I got this nice award. Saying,
no one cares.
Having good relay spirit.
No one cares.
All right.
No one cares.
I thought it was pretty cool.
No one cares.
There's only like 7 people at the party. So there wasn't a lot of people there.
I care. That's who cares.
Absolutely.
So I'm looking forward to next year's relay. And I called up Jason to see if he can help out.
Okay, get in the microphone, man. I called up
Jason yesterday to see if he can help promote next year's relay because the guy was talking up Concord's community television. I said, hey, I know the guy that runs the Manchester community public television. His name is Jason. He's been here a long time.
I'm sure they know each other.
Mm. Well, I don't know. They probably do.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they do.
Yeah, so hopefully he can help promote next year's relay, and that would be a good thing.
You're already getting into next year's relay.
Well, this year's relay is over.
Today's the first day of summer, Ease, okay?
Yeah, so, happy summer.
So why don't you ease up on everybody?
I thought the relay was Saturday.
No, it was a couple weeks ago.
Oh. Apparently missed it.
No, Saturday is the Fisher Cats game.
Oh, right.
Right.
Sorry.
Yeah. Right?
All right. That's my my short commercial for the relay. Moving on.
Oh, okay. Can we move on now?
Yep.
Can we move on?
We got the authorization from Eazy-G to move on.
What's going on over at Creamland?
We don't want to know. I hope I work today. I yesterday off because I had a lot of errands to run.
Right.
I went to my doctor's appointment. Good news, my cellulitis is left town again, so that's a good thing.
Oh, cellulitis is gone?
Yeah,
okay, let me ask you this. How much cream did they actually use at Creamland?
a valid question.
They probably use a lot because they make their own ice cream. So.
Right. They use cream for that?
Probably. My boss, Nicole, spends many hours doing
it. Ask her how much cream Creamland uses.
All right, we'll do that later. hopefully I'll be doing that later. Yes, I hope I work at least 3 hours.
So everything's good inside the job place. Everything's good. You're not having a problem with anything.
No, I just wish I was there more often. That's all.
Right,
but that's okay though.
What goes on behind the scenes, like with you and the coworkers? Do you generally have a good time with them?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Good. Oh, okay.
It's a fun work environment, is what you're saying. We get along very well.
Okay.
I just wish I was there more often, but my health hasn't been the best.
No, your health is awful.
Yeah. It's getting better, though.
No, but on a rating of 1 to 10, your health is probably like an 11.
Well, it's getting better, though, because I'm able to squeeze into my 9.5.
Does that even make sense?
My 9.5 sneakers today for the first time in months last night. And I got new shoes here in size 11 now instead of 13. So.
Oh, right. Going down in size.
Yeah.
And that's a good thing.
Right.
Right. Not waiting around those horrible big boots. I put those away till winter.
Okay, good. Good.
So I think I'm on the uprise right now.
Yeah, I think you are too.
I think I'm even looking forward to maybe working at this new arena August 1st.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm still technically working there, even though I haven't worked there for 2 months. Now my feet feel a little better. I think I might try to keep that job. Because even though
Do you think they forgot about you already?
It's a smaller part-time job because the Monarchs are gone now, but there's still some money coming in, so I'd be stupid to say goodbye to it.
Right. Yeah, because you have to say goodbye to Creamland in October or whenever they close.
Right.
Now, are you going to cry when that happens? Will you cry on that day?
When you
say goodbye to everybody that you worked with all summer long at Creamland?
I'll have to deal with that when I deal with it. I'm not going to worry about it now. It's only June.
I don't know why.
You know, I got a theory. Since Creamland closes around October, you would have gained valuable knowledge and experience.
Right.
So you could just truck right over to Goldenrod and pick right up all through the winter months.
Right. Don't even need any training.
No.
You're already there, man. Training.
I'm trying to get into that restaurant down the street there. They're supposed to be opened up by the, City Hall.
Yes.
But I don't know when they're opening.
Yeah, I don't know either.
I reached out to them on Facebook saying, when are you hiring? And they haven't called me.
You figured they would call you back. You're Eazy-G.
Well, I don't know when they're opening, so.
You know?
And apparently,
that would be a nice close place to walk. So I need to find a place that's not.
Were you walking
away
in the rain? Was I sitting up here and looking outside? Saw you across the street, walking across the plaza over here in the rain with an umbrella.
Yep. When was this?
Yesterday. I don't know.
Yesterday. I was sitting in the rain. Yep.
Yeah, and it was pouring out, and I saw you kind of waddling over through the
through the Plaza. I'm like, that's Eric.
Yep, that was me.
And I felt, you know, I was like, wow, but you look like you were having a blast.
I don't know about that.
Nothing holds down this guy.
No, that's absolutely right, Darryl.
Rain, snow, thunder, lightning. He's out there.
You are the man, man.
I try.
Yeah. All right. 250-6007.
He apparently doesn't want to work at Goldenrod, though, sadly.
The phone lines are open. And Facebook Live is open. We'll say good morning to Miriam. Banish, good morning. Angela, good morning to you. Debbie, Lorendo, and of course, Chrissy Cantor in the Facebook Live. I'm up early this morning because she is on her way in. She'll be here soon.
Well, hi, Chrissy. We'll see you tomorrow.
And our good friend, Bill Burke. Good morning.
Oh, hi, Bill.
Yeah,
hi.
That's right.
Hi, Angela.
Right. And John Clayton. Don't forget John.
Yeah, I saw him the other day at the basket. I gave him a friendly reminder.
Yeah, what? No, you told me this. There was a John Clayton sighting over at Market Basket.
Yeah, I always
right?
see him there at the basket. I said, see you Saturday. He go, oh, Saturday? I said, yeah, the fish guy game. He said, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'll see you there.
He seemed pretty enthusiastic or what?
Yeah, John's going to the game. John's going to the game.
I think either the Chief bought him a ticket or Mike Doyle bought him a ticket.
Wow, everyone's getting tickets around here for stuff except me.
I didn't see a ticket.
Yeah, did you get a ticket, Darryl?
No.
Are you going to the Fisher Cats game Saturday?
No, I got no ticket.
No, me neither.
Well, I offered you to buy a ticket, Darryl, but you were you said that it wasn't a good idea because you were getting ready for your surgery.
That's true. He's getting ready for surgery.
Well, I am in prep mode.
I offered you a ticket to go, Peter, but you declined, so that's okay, though.
Wait, how do you know I declined? Did you ask me?
Yes, I did.
Oh, and I said no?
Nope. That's okay, though.
Okay, well, at least I told you right out.
I got a lot of yeses, so I got to get some no's. It's a way.
But you don't hold it against me, right?
I don't. Not like the guy from DEFCON.
Yeah, the DEFCON guy. Forget it.
Wait, they need to show up for your show.
Right.
And even getting up at 6 o'clock.
Right.
Can't you bring me some muffins? Oh my god, that was so funny.
Oh,
I'm not gonna forget that show for a long time. That was funny.
Yeah, hey, we're Scumpy. You've been calling about Scumpy. You should answer my phone calls.
Yeah, speaking of him, he's got a big show tomorrow.
Secret. Later.
What'd you say now?
He's got a big show in Concord tomorrow, so hopefully the DEF CON fans will get out and support him.
Right.
It's not my cup of tea.
No, not your cup of tea. No, that's tomorrow up in Concord?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was last week. No,
I think it's this Saturday.
No, it was last week, wasn't it?
I thought it was last week.
Yeah. Why are you screwing people up, man?
Oh, yeah, it was last week.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
You're right.
All
right.
First day of summer, everybody. Happy summer. Summer is always fun. Go ahead, Darryl.
I want to just a slight correction. We are inching closer. 11:54 a.m. this morning is the first
official
beginning
day
of summer, officially.
Oh, okay.
You
so
know, I didn't
right.
want to correct you.
Technically,
I didn't want to.
Technically,
you know.
we are
still in spring.
We're really, still really, really close.
Right. And if your birthday is today, you can say, well, my birthday's in spring and summer.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
You know?
Two seasons.
Mine is on September 18th, Ease, if you want to mark that on your calendar.
Yeah, right. It's already in my log.
Right.
Yeah.
Free ice cream day over at Goldenrod, September 18th.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
On my birthday.
Oh, boy.
Thank you very much, Goldenrod. What a day.
Absolutely. You know, I got a feeling if we could find a way to transport this bad boy to Goldenrod's, he would take a job there. But we got to get him there.
Right.
No buses out there?
Oh, yeah. I think there's a bus that goes out to the lake, the circle.
Right.
Yeah, but then there's certain days that the bus isn't available. And then,
well, how do you know?
You know, you
the holidays.
Check the schedule.
Well, yeah, you
we
can work that out.
We just want to hook you up with more employment through the winter months.
Right. At a place that has a bathroom for the public.
And you'll be experienced. Holy crap.
Right.
I think I'm all set.
What do you mean you're all set? We're trying to help you here. Come on, man.
It's too far.
It's not that far.
10 miles away.
You know, I put a picture up on the morning show page of you, a nice artsy black and white photo.
I saw that.
Yeah, did you see that?
I shared it on my page.
Oh, no. Not the picture of us in the elevator. I'm talking about just you sitting right there.
Oh, I didn't see that one.
Yeah, I know. Why didn't you get in the microphone?
Oh, I
told you four times already today.
I'm sorry. My first day here. I didn't see that one.
Yeah, I know you didn't. That's why I'm telling you about
it. I shared the elevator one. I got a couple hits on it.
All right, so it's not quite summer yet, everybody.
Really, really close.
Yeah, a couple hours away.
Yeah, technically.
So, it was funny when I saw that this morning. I figured I'd just interject.
Well, thank you, Darryl. I appreciate it. I'm going to miss that when you're away.
I'll bet you will.
Yes. All right, well, it is June 21st. Anne and Samantha Day is the first one I have today.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, exactly.
That's weird.
Let's move on.
Well, No, I'm going to tell you. Why don't you ask me what it is?
What is this?
Oh, what it is?
Anne and Samantha Day, which takes place twice a year on the summer and winter solstices,
oh,
is dedicated to Anne Frank and Samantha Smith. The day was created to put Anne and Samantha on a U.S. postage stamp.
Oh.
So, come on now.
Really?
Is there anyone out there? Where you going, man? We're in the middle of a show. Oh, my God. All right. So, yeah. I don't know. Is anyone celebrating that day?
No.
Okay. It's Cuckoo Warning Day. I'd like to tell you what that is.
Cuckoo? As in cuckoo the clock?
Yeah, that's what it says. And it just says it's always on this day. That's all it says.
Okay. That's enough of that.
All right. You ever skateboard, man?
No.
No? It's National Go Skateboarding Day.
Is it still as popular as it was, 20, 30 years ago?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. There's some kids out there skating.
Skateboard park still?
Yeah. Manchester's, believe, making a new one somewhere, or I heard something about it, because the old one closed.
And where was the old one?
On Maple Street, over behind the Hunt Memorial Pool.
Got it.
Right.
I didn't even know it existed.
Yeah, no, it was there for a lot of years. But it fell into disrepair. And,
oh, okay.
You know.
But they got a new one. Is it already built, ready to go?
I don't know. If anyone has any news on the skate park, I don't know. I don't have any information on it.
Yeah. Ben and Samantha, they were into that. They were not into that either.
No?
Yeah.
Ben didn't have a skateboard?
No.
He must have had a bike.
No.
He didn't even have a bike?
Well, he had a bike, but...
He didn't ride his bicycle?
No.
Ben Dion didn't ride a bicycle?
You don't want to go there.
Okay. Sorry, Ben. Sorry, my friend. I feel bad now. Everyone knows about his...
Don't feel bad.
Fear of bikes.
No fear.
Oh, boy. I was getting myself into trouble here.
A little bit.
All right. National Day of Prayer for law enforcement officers. That's okay.
Absolutely. They're out there risking their lives daily.
I agree. So, yeah, I just said a short little prayer for our friend Nick Willard.
All right.
That's right.
Clean shaven, Nick Willard.
I know, right? I wonder, he doesn't get the new talks. I don't think he does. I'm going to recommend it to him, though.
You can have a conversation about that.
I will, because I think he cares about what he looks like.
Absolutely.
Like, he cares about his features.
And you know what's going on with that.
Yeah, I do. Yes, kind of. I'll tell you what, though, that stuff, you really start
you
to feel it. Oh, yeah. I have another week to go where it's, because it's still doing its magic.
Has it become more intense?
Magic.
More intense or less intense?
It's intense. It feels like kind of tight,
so still,
and good.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So this stuff
is
working.
It lasts for 3 or 4 months, but when you do get it injected, it takes about 2 weeks for it to take its full effect.
Right. Yeah. Can't wait to see it.
Until it works, it's magic. Because that's all I know about it. I'm not a,
scientist.
Right. I just think it's magic. All right. Welcome back, Eazy-G.
Hi.
Yeah.
Still got some more days left?
Yeah. I was waiting for you.
Oh, boy.
International Day of Yoga. That's okay. I did yoga once.
I did it one time, too. Well, more than once. I did it one time at the YMCA, and I hurt myself. I should know better.
Really?
You hurt yourself doing yoga.
I took an advanced class.
Why would you take an advanced class?
I don't know, because it was free.
You needed to take the beginner class.
It was a free week, and I just hurt myself.
I had a hard time with the beginner class.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Well, because, you twist your body, do stuff.
All kinds of contortions, right?
My sister and her husband are big into it. They've been doing it for years.
Well, yeah. Yoga's good for you.
It's supposedly good for you.
No, it is.
But for me, it's not.
No, just because you had one bad experience, you can't.
I think you should try it again.
It's like that damn burger, Oh, I didn't like the burger. Then I had one after 14 years.
No, but the mild yoga is good, but the advanced, forget it.
Okay, well, that's what you work your way up to, man.
Exactly. Right. You start.
You get
start
bored with the beginner stuff, and then,
All right.
International Surfing Day. You guys like surfing?
My sister has done it.
I bet.
Really?
She has.
She surfed in Hawaii?
Yep.
Outstanding. No, I never tried it.
No.
Surfing around here is a little,
Well, there's a...
You can.
I don't know how good she is, but she's tried it.
Right. But there is a... out at the beach, over at North Beach up in Hampton. You can catch the surfers out there.
Yeah, the waves aren't too
high. On a good day, some days they are, though.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I've been out there, and I've seen some pretty good stuff.
Just observe them, yeah?
Yeah.
I think it's fun to watch.
It is. I like watching it.
No, most definitely. And when they get in that, the wave comes, and they're in the middle of it, that... I don't know, that funnel
Oh, yeah.
It's wild.
Wasn't there a Brady Bunch episode with that?
That's right. Thank you for saying that.
I think that's where we're headed.
Well, I always think when we talk about Hawaii, I always think about the Brady Bunch going to Hawaii.
How many weeks did they spend there? A couple?
Well, Mike was designing something for his firm. So took the family out to Hawaii.
Didn't they find a bag luck charm or something, tiki thing or something?
Yeah. And then they went to Mr. Hanale, and he goes, "Oh no, that's tiki bad luck."
Yeah. Oh boy.
Mr. Hanale, help us.
See, he even got the dialogue down. Holy mackerel!
Oh, it's ridiculous.
Oh man,
it's not a bad thing. You enjoyed it.
Well, you know what? Every time that tiki showed up, it always went do 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 do. Yeah, Peter almost got bit by a spider.
Oh jeez.
Greg had a wipeout.
There we go.
Crazy. It was a crazy episode. Vincent Price was in the damn episode.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Whoa.
Right.
He was not a young man at that time.
No, he was living in a cave in Hawaii. He actually tied up three boys in a cave.
Oh, he did.
And then at the end of the show, he's sitting around the thing having whatever poi with him at some luau.
Yeah. Oh boy.
That's funny. He tied the boys up. Three boys.
The Brady Boys,
game.
Right? Brady Boys?
That's right. Greg, Peter, and Bobby, Darryl.
Yeah. I read that book about the Brady Bunch. You ever read that one?
No, I've read it.
Oh, boy. Was it good or what?
Well, what? Growing Up Brady?
Yeah, that was really good.
By Barry Williams?
That was really
Who
good.
Who plays Greg Brady?
Supposedly there was a hanky-panky going on behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Do you believe it?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, probably. They were kids. They were just teenagers, you know?
In the doghouse.
Right. More hanky panky was going on there than behind the scenes on this show. Are you all right?
No.
What was that?
A cough.
On the microphone? No, we're on the radio.
I caught it.
We're on the radio.
I caught it. One like that.
Well, you didn't catch it. You didn't catch it.
All right.
You got to get the funk off of that microphone.
That's right.
Atta boy.
National Selfie Day. Do you take selfies, Darryl?
No.
You're going to start taking some selfies.
I probably will at some point in time.
Well, you're going to have nothing to do for the next couple of weeks, so just take some selfies.
It's highly unlikely it's going to happen then.
Okay. With your left hand. Yes.
It's going to be wild.
These selfies, no?
Well, speaking of phones, either Saturday or Monday, my friend Heidi has given me her old smartphone, so maybe I'll start taking some.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll be looking forward to that.
I'm going to transfer my government service into my new smartphone.
Your government service into your new smartphone.
So the phone you have now, you can't do the pictures.
No.
Okay. That's a flip-up, right?
But I'm still going to keep this phone. But you can transfer the 1,000 minutes into the smartphone.
Excellent.
Wow.
Yeah, all you can do is call the service.
It's pretty exciting.
Yeah, you can't beat the price he's giving it to me. So. Good friend.
That is a good friend. That's a better friend than I am.
She has a new, better one. So.
She's a better friend than I am, you would say?
No, but no. She,
no, but who's a better friend? Who's your best friend in all the world? Let me ask you a real serious question.
All right.
Okay. If, you know, you had to choose, like, say you had to get rid of one of us out of your life, okay?
Oh, boy.
All right? And you had to choose between myself, Goldenrod Peter, or Matt Connerton from the Matt Connerton Unleashed in the Afternoon show.
I'm not going to answer that because later
No, you have to answer it. You have to answer
That's big trouble.
Right.
I'll get rid of Matt, I guess.
You're going to what?
I'll get rid of Matt.
No, I can't hear you.
I'll get rid of Matt.
Okay.
Sorry, Matt.
You would get rid of Matt?
And how would you get rid of him?
Yeah, what would we do?
I need to know that.
This guy, I'll fire him. You're fired.
You're fired? You're going to fire Matt?
Yeah, like the Donald Trump.
I don't know if you have the authority to do that.
No, I don't think he does.
No, he doesn't.
I'm just joking around, Matt. You know that.
I don't think that's a joke.
I went on the show the other day. It was funny.
I know.
Oh, you were here the other day?
Yeah, a couple days ago, yeah.
Oh, cool. Yeah, he tries to get as much airtime as he can from everywhere.
He's got to.
I was only out for 50 minutes before the Relay for Life right. party there. Yeah.
All right, let's get this. I have more days.
Oh, boy.
And we have to get to Carol.
Yeah, true.
It's National Seashell Day. Great. Everyone, yeah. Okay.
Seashells by the seashore.
Right.
I got a seashell at Bob Moody's.
Not easy to say.
Bob Moody's wake.
What's that?
I have a seashell. Bob Moody's wake. He was a big beach person.
Really?
The guy that passed away at the Snow Arena.
Oh, okay.
I'm still wrapping myself around that.
Wrap yourself around this. It's National Day of the Gong.
Oh, boy.
I love it.
And when Darryl gets back, Darryl has a great idea, speaking of Gong. Yes. And I'm just going to leave it at that.
Okay.
When he gets back from his little sabbatical that he's going on.
Oh, boy.
yeah, I was thinking about that yesterday, too.
Yeah. You'll have plenty of time to get that going.
Yeah, absolutely. I can do that from the phone.
Right. Absolutely. National Peaches and Cream Day. Mm-hmm. No, thank you.
I kind of like peaches and cream.
Yeah, I do too.
But well, okay, guys. If it agrees, you don't have to. You don't have to come at me like that. It's Friday. All right, it's take your dog to work day. I'm sure everyone's going to like that in the office.
Absolutely.
No, well, I'll show you. Daughter does it all the time. She works at home.
In the corner.
Yes.
Your daughter works at home.
Can't believe you got rid of Matt.
Sorry, Matt. I wasn't going to get rid of you. You were in front of me. Oh,
thank you. Thank you.
Only because he was right in front of you.
But if Matt asked you on his show, you would have said, got rid of me.
Yep.
Oh, damn.
Sorry.
You know what?
Nothing with personal.
It is personal.
With the look on his face, he's not sorry at all.
It's personal.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not.
All right. It's the first day of summer. We know that. It is National Take Back the Lunch Break Day. Thank you. Always like a lunch break.
Oh, yeah. Got to.
All right. Let's see what else there is. Ugliest Dog Day. Okay, yeah. And believe it or not, go ahead, Eazy-G. What?
I'm sorry.
Trying to wrap these up.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go on. Go on, Goldenrod Pete.
Okay, thank you.
Goldenrod Pete.
Thank you. It is World Giraffe Day.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's right. For the giraffe.
It's too many of them.
World Handshake Day, everybody.
I like the fist bump.
You like the what?
Fist bump instead.
So when you're at church and they say, peace be with you, and you shake hands, you just give them a fist bump?
No.
I gotta see that.
I do the handshake, but...
Oh, good, right. Good.
Outside of church, I do this.
Okay, well, thank you.
Oh, I got another day today, too, real quick. 33 years ago today, I graduated at Gospel High School.
Really? Did you stay back?
No, I did not. It was a lot warmer today than it is today, though. It was like 90,000 degrees.
Really?
Oh, my God. It was awful.
So you graduated today. Yep. What'd you do on your graduation night? Did you guys celebrate? Did you guys go over to T-Bones?
No, we went over to Gagnon Mountain.
Gagnon Mountain. What'd you guys do over there?
I had a big dinner.
Really?
Celebration dinner, yep.
Wow.
Yep.
I don't know, man. What are you doing this weekend?
I might be working this weekend, so I don't know my schedule yet, so I'll find out when I get there. Boss hasn't called me off yet, so that's a good sign.
You're listening to Peter White. Call us at 250-6007. It's the morning show.
This is Manchester's WMNH 95.3 FM.
And it's time for Carol Lobado from ManchesterInkling.com.
All right, that's an old school intro.
I love it.
Good morning.
Yaman. Yaman.
Hey, Carol. Hey, Eric.
Morning, Carol. I reached out to Laura yesterday and I said, boy, we missed you on the show. I'm planning on coming back soon.
Yeah, Laura will be here next week, I think, or coming up July 1st.
Oh, cool.
I believe.
Laura's the best.
She's going to make her return.
Return?
Yes.
I would never get rid of Laura.
Do we know what she's doing? She's doing
it doesn't matter what she does. She can just come on in.
Right.
Right, Carol?
That's right.
So
you have really assembled quite a dream team.
Yes, yes. The best of the best.
Yeah, yeah. You have so many good people in your corner.
Right, right, yes.
You do.
I don't even know how it happened.
I know. I mean, it's funny, isn't it, how it just happens like that? But you did it.
People have come and gone, and then new people always come in.
Oh, please. People go.
Yeah, that's fine. That's life.
That's right. Thank you. Thank you. Are you my therapist now?
Yeah.
Damn.
We all need one.
Yes.
No, we don't.
Well, sometimes we do.
Okay. Now, did you say you were going to be here for how much longer?
4 minutes.
Okay.
I'll be counting them down.
Yes. I am counting them down, too.
All right, I'm going to shut up now. It's your time, Carol.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, boy. So what's going on?
What's going on? Well, my sister's coming today. That's the big news in my world.
You guys are going to see Josh Groban.
We are. Oh, we absolutely are.
Not to be confused.
Where's he playing?
At the Schnoo.
At the Schnoo.
Schnoo? Really?
Yeah. Not to be confused with Josh Logan.
Right.
you'll have to give us a full report on Monday.
Can you imagine if you thought you bought Josh Logan tickets and you go there and it's Josh Groban.
Yeah. I'm going to the Real Life for Life official game.
We know you're going there, man. Stop.
Sorry.
Can't is it, Carol, is it a younger or older sister?
She's 2 years older.
2 years older? Okay.
But she's way cuter. Yeah.
Wait, stop it. Just stop it.
Yeah, stop
Really? I wouldn't mind seeing it. I wouldn't mind seeing a picture of her.
Yeah, me too.
Okay.
Just send it on over. Why don't you send it on over?
Yeah, well, she's coming in at around like 2 or 2:30. So maybe I'll take her to the office so she can see my cool digs. And if you're there, we'll say hi. If you're in the
I'm down here today for a little while. I got to I'm manning the fort here for a little while today.
What's her hometown, Carol?
L-town.
Oh, Levittown. Home of the Levittown Brown.
Yes.
Yeah, she's a home girl. She's a townie. So
over there in Bucks County, Pennsylvania.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's right.
Wow.
Yeah, so she's coming. I mean, she told me like a month ago she gave me some Josh Groban suggestions to listen to. I haven't gotten too far. I think it's going to be okay though. It doesn't work with my ears yet. I haven't figured it out what it is about Josh Groban that I don't see.
Hey, he's probably a nice guy.
I'm sure he's funny. I just shows and stuff. Yeah.
You know,
so he's a singer, right? That's what he does.
Oh yeah, he's a singer.
Yeah, I think one of the latest things he did was like a bunch of Broadway tunes, like that he re-released. Which
oh
I was
great! I'm gonna run out and get that right after the show.
Well, Carol, my friend of mine went years ago, and he didn't really turn the audience over. So
he what?
Hopefully, the audience wasn't that impressed, I guess.
How do you know? What do you mean?
A friend of mine went.
Oh, because your friend
said
that.
He surveyed the entire audience.
Yeah. His friend is an expert in audiences.
I mean, I think he's really beloved by the people that love him.
Right.
But, you know, it's just funny that she loves him so much, and I never have really gotten it. But you know, we always had our differences in music
that's
growing
one
up
of them.
And I have to say that she, as my older sister back in the 70s, she did introduce me to a lot of music that she had discovered before I did. One of them was like early Genesis. She really loved them. And Bruce Springsteen, she got his first album when it was like brand new and brought it home, and we liked that together. You know, there was a lot of stuff we had in common, but I was really more into the R&B stuff, you know.
And
she was more into the, although we both love Yes in Chicago.
Right, but were you, do you think you're going to have to listen to Josh Groban on the way down to the arena?
Yeah.
Now, that really sucks.
I think
Josh Groban's
enough is enough.
Josh Groban's probably in town right now. He could be listening to this broadcast.
Yeah, quite possible.
Oh my gosh. All right.
Sorry, Josh Groban.
Yeah.
Welcome to Manchester.
I want to apologize as well because I thought he was a comedian. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Well, I saw Michael Bublé a couple of years ago with the Snoo Rate. I didn't really know nothing about him.
Who'd you see?
Michael Bublé.
And that was a great show. So on that note, I got to go.
Well, that's why I'm saying, you know, you never know, because I also went to see, there was an a cappella group, I forget the name of them now, but they were very popular, that played there, and I went, and it was great. Like, it's not always my cup of tea, but I think it's going to be fine, and I'm looking forward mostly just hanging out with my sister, trying to figure out where we're going to go hang out, like, before or after.
Right,
yeah,
right,
and
right.
Then that's not till Saturday. So we have tonight to figure out, and I don't know, but it's just fun to have her here. She hasn't been here in a while, so.
So you haven't seen her in a while?
I haven't. I see her when I go to Pennsylvania,
right?
But she hasn't been here for a while, so.
Okay. So
I'd like. I know she hasn't seen my.
Have a great weekend. Carol. Eric's making his grand exit as he usually does.
I understand.
He's trying to get his carriage through the door.
And I'm sure there's some cool places that she hasn't seen. Like she might like a place like Boards and Brews because she, she likes to play games. She always used to give me games for like Christmas.
Oh yeah. Speaking of, I'm sorry to interrupt,
it's okay.
But I told a story last Saturday over at the Pride Day. There's a story I didn't tell. Keating Tufts and his some of his staff were over there playing games with people. And there was a card game that we played. I forget what it was called, but it was like you had to switch around and move around and fist bump and do. What is it?
No, I just said, oh, neat. That sounds like a fun game. You got to figure out.
Yeah, they were. Yeah, it was interesting. It was good.
Does Keating listen in the morning? Maybe he could call in. He's listening.
And yeah, tell us what game it was.
Yeah, I forget what it was, but he did a great job getting. I don't know if he's a fan of the mornings or not, but
I said morning show.
Oh yeah, maybe he listens to the afternoon replay.
Okay. All right. Well, maybe he can let you know, because that would be good to know.
Yeah, we can play here on the show.
Absolutely.
Yeah, like during the show.
Yeah, we can. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Very good. Yeah. So,
so
your sister,
plan.
Josh Groban's probably going to call in this morning and complain.
Oh,
like, what's your beef with me?
I mean, no, but like, so that's what I think that's the bottom line there is just listening to something on, you know, a CD or whatever. It's sometimes it just doesn't do anything for you, but the live experience, even if you're not a big fan of somebody, you can discover for the first time how charming they are, how cool they are, just a different experience. Case in point. And I have liked Tom Petty's music, you know, my whole life, because I grew up with Tom Petty. But if I had to, you know, pick like who's going to live and who's going to die, you know, if Tom Petty was like floating in the ocean with a bunch of other people and I could only save one person, it wouldn't be Tom Petty. Just because he wasn't like among my favorite performers or anything. He was okay, right?
Right.
In my mind, he was okay. Like, it was like, I know all these songs, I can sing every lyric, but, you know, he's not exactly in my zone. Right. But then I had.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, stop dragging my heart. Is that dragging my heart around?
No, it's not. It's The Waiting.
The Waiting. Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. That's the one I threw out there. I always forget Tom Petty is dead.
Oh, yeah.
It happened kind
of
all of a sudden.
He's one of the many acts that I had to go cover when I used to, my beat was the Verizon, when I worked for the Union Leader. And I went to a Tom Petty show and I didn't want to leave. It was so
good.
I was like acting like a super fan all of a sudden. You know, every single song that came on, it just was terrific, and I'm singing my heart out. You know, it was like something about being there.
Oh yeah,
the live thing.
Tom Petty, rock royalty. Rock royalty, as far as I'm concerned, Tom Petty. You know why? You know what puts him into rock royalty? He was a traveling Wilbury.
Yes, he was.
Oh, okay. See, and there again, the traveling Wilburys. I mean, I appreciated, I guess, some of the stuff they did, but it's something about that wheelhouse of a little bit, it gets a little bit country or gets a little bit folky or something. I can't explain it, that it's like, it's okay. You know, a little toe tap in there, but it doesn't speak to my soul. And that's all I can say. It's decent music, but
really,
and that's why it's funny, right? Like, we all have our thing.
Absolutely.
Like, music and politics and religion. So personal.
No, you know it. And, you know, it's interesting, too, because in the Wilburys, there's so many different kind of guys in there. We're talking about George Harrison.
Yes.
Talking about Bob Dylan.
Jeff Lynne.
Roy Orbison. Right? I mean, there's so many different kinds of musicians in there. And for them to actually bring it all together, it couldn't have been easy.
Yeah, I mean.
I like this one. You can dig it. You hate this, Carol. I can tell. You hate it.
No, you hate it.
I'm going to shut it off just for you.
No, I wanted to hear it a little bit longer so I could put my finger on what it is about that kind of music.
Yeah, let's do it. You know what, though? I like this other one better.
Okay, go ahead.
This is the one I like better.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that one better.
Yeah, me too.
Being beat up and battered around. Oh, it's good. Being sent up and I've been shut down. And that's Jeff. That's Jeff Lynne singing, I believe. Correct? Am I right?
I think you're right.
From ELO.
Yes. Yeah, that's. I tell you, that is so different. But Carol is right insofar as for me as well. It was just a little bit too countryish.
You know, a little countryish and a little basic. If that's, you know how that word
yeah,
is used.
Yeah,
these
absolutely.
Days. It's like a little, like I can see people doing the two step or like.
Right. Spin your partner around and round.
I like really complicated square dancing music sometimes. Like I like music where there's so much going on, your head is spinning.
Right.
And like bass, gotta have a really, you know, banging bass line. You
strong
know,
bass.
Blah, blah, blah,
yeah.
blah, blah, blah. Like right. I love that. You know, I could get lost in that kind of music. Or like Yes.
Oh, man.
Chicago, oof. There's so much going on. In the,
I think that's why I love Chicago as well. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, Ed Murphy in the Facebook Live room has a question for you, Carol. He would like to know who else you would drown other than Tom Petty.
Yeah, no, I didn't say I would drown. It was just one of those hypotheticals. It's like when they give you that hypothetical and they say, would you save your children or your spouse? Like, that's not going to happen. But
that's not going
to
happen.
One of those, just one of those questions of life that you have to think about. The reasoning of what, you know, why you would do what you do. And I guess, you know, I can only say that after I saw Tom Petty live, I would definitely not let him drown. I would definitely swim extra hard to save everybody out of the water.
Tom Petty,
everybody.
Tom Petty, yeah, came through Manchester when we had our concerts on the river back in the late 80s, early 90s. Yes. Tom Petty, and he brought the Heartbreakers with him. Can you believe it?
The Heartbreakers.
I believe it.
Hey, Carol, who's the opening act for Josh Groban? Is there an opening
Josh
act?
Josh Logan.
Gotcha.
It's that guy that plays the trumpet or something. I know he's pretty famous too, but I can't remember his name. Geez. Someone in the
Kenny G?
Live room.
No, he plays the sax.
I know. I don't care. He plays a horn. All right.
It's a
horn
know
player.
Is it I can't think of it, but it's
I'm trying to think of a popular trumpet player as well. I can't. I'm not.
Well, he.
It's not,
you know,
Marcellus, right? It's not one of the Marcellus brothers. Can't
no,
be. It
no,
can't be. No,
that's they, you know,
it's some white dude.
Oh, okay.
I forget his name.
He plays a trumpet. All he does is he's known for playing the trumpet.
Not a clue.
Chris Botti. B-O-T-T-I.
Okay, I've heard the name before.
Yeah.
He's probably in town too, so I'm gonna watch.
You better
my
be
step.
Careful.
We won't talk about Josh or Chris till tomorrow when they leave town.
I'm a big fan of brass too, so I might like it. Like I like horn playing, you know. I like music.
Brass, the brass instruments.
The brass, yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, Carol. In just a few short months, I'm gonna give you a little treat. If I start playing the sax, we'll get some brass.
Really? Yeah. Daryl's gonna bring the. Can you bring the sax in? Can you play it on the air here?
I would think so.
Oh wow! Can you play Baker Street by Jerry Rafferty?
I'd probably pay anything.
No way.
Yeah, I like that song.
Well, yeah,
you know, you practice anything. You can play anything.
Baker Street.
Yeah, that's an interesting song, isn't it?
It is.
That's got the sax intro, right?
Yeah, it has a...
I think it was an alto sax in that intro.
Okay. Whatever,
I play tenor. But I could still pull it off.
Wow. I don't know. I played clarinet once in my life. And
cut
it
out.
Yeah, in fifth grade.
I
didn't stick with it. I was the only kid that got up in class at a special time to go for my clarinet lesson. The only kid in school taking clarinet.
Hey, don't knock it.
Weirdo.
I play the clarinet.
I know. I'm sorry. I was 10. I got a lot of flack.
We finally
have to go
to
school
to
with
it.
A little suitcase.
And it's then very little suitcase.
Yeah, it's a little suitcase, and you have to open it up and then assemble this clarinet.
It's not a clarinet. It's a liquor stick.
It is. I don't know.
That's the...
Sorry, Carol. Just going back to my clarinet days.
That's fine.
All the other kids who had drum pads. Not me.
I had a drum pad.
Yeah, because you're one of the cool kids. I had a clarinet.
Yeah.
How'd you get to the clarinet?
I was the only.
I don't know.
It's odd.
You know what? Probably my cousin played the clarinet. My older cousin in Maryland played the clarinet. And so I said, yeah, I'll play it.
That looks cool.
No.
I got tons of crap, you know, staying in and practicing the clarinet at 10 years old.
Yeah, no
all
thanks.
All my pals are outside, you know.
With their drum pads.
No.
You had a drum pad, Carol?
Yeah, I played the drum. And I wanted my son to play the saxophone, but he was advised to learn the clarinet first, and he didn't like the clarinet, so that never happened.
Yeah, see, they turn people off.
Well, playing the clarinet first enables you to play the saxophone much more easily. because your lip is in shape. You're ready to go.
Really?
It's just the larger and, you know, the you know, conflagration of the notes are, you know, very similar.
Any of you ever blow on a tuba?
No tuba.
No.
No.
What are the purpose of a tuba? Can you really, can you,
boom,
just
boom,
like a bassy?
Boom, boom. Yeah, right, pretty much. Right. Tempo.
Okay. Tempo. Tempo. All yeah, right,
they're,
Darryl.
They're pretty exciting. When, like, the marching band, when you see them, you know, in that parade.
I find it fascinating. It's so big.
The students, yeah, there's a few of them, and they really are, they make them probably way more lightweight than they used to be.
Yeah, they're John Philip Sousa. Boom, boom.
Oh, really?
76 trombones. It's beautiful.
Really? Okay, wow. That's a history lesson right there, Darryl. Thank you. Trying to get it all in before Darryl. You know, Darryl's leaving for a little while, Carol.
I'm not going far.
I heard. Yeah. Good for him.
What are we going to do?
I might
put a gone fishing sign up on the window. And I won't be fishing. All right. So what are you doing this weekend, Carol? Anything fun?
I hope so.
Groban.
My sister's here, so.
Yeah, I know. Groban, but now, okay, so Groban, you get all that out of the way. Then what's the next day?
I don't know. Well, no, that's Saturday. She's okay. Coming today, but then we don't have to do that till Saturday night. So
oh, okay. So.
To figure out.
Oh, you'll be out. So you may be out
today,
and about. Like, yes.
Night. Yep. And then tomorrow, you know, we can find some stuff to do. If anybody has any suggestions, I'm open.
It's going
to
be a nice weekend. That's for sure.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, it looks like it. I checked the weather before the show.
Oh, okay.
Well, because, you know, I think most people already know what the weather. Oh, it's going to be about 80 degrees.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's going to be nice. You could probably go swimming in your pool.
Yeah, I guess I should tell her to bring her bathing suit if she wants to.
Yeah, I think so. So what's going on? A pretty quiet news day yesterday, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, there was like a SWAT situation that we haven't sorted out yet, but it seems like it was related to something happening in Massachusetts, where they did have this major drug bust yesterday, which anybody might have seen on the news. It's like a huge, the biggest one they've ever had or something. And it was, according to one of the press releases I saw, it was initiated in part because Manchester police wanted to figure out the source of a lot of the drugs coming here, and it led them to this big drug bust in Lawrence or something. So hopefully we'll get some more info on that, since I don't know. I'm not saying that the SWAT thing yesterday was related to that, but I'm just saying it's connected to Massachusetts somehow. So Manchester police did not have information available on it yesterday.
The investigation is ongoing? Is that
ongoing.
What you're saying?
It's ongoing, as always.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
I got my knee looked at yesterday.
Okay.
My bum knee.
Yeah. What's that looking like?
Well, you know, it looks bad. No, it doesn't look bad, but I got a shot of cortisone, so we'll see what happens.
But eventually you will probably need some sort of surgery?
If I want to. I mean,
right.
It just depends on if you, like, I've always thought, you know, it might be cool to have a fancy cane. And like a pimp hat or whatever. You know?
Yeah, I can see that. I can see that.
Do you have to have a bionic knee, or can you just like work with your disability and kind of, you know?
You could probably rock a cane.
Yeah.
But then wears a cane, though. I mean, not wears a cane, but someone uses a cane. You're like, oh, the guy needs a cane. That's too bad.
Unless it's like really, like a really flashy one. Like, you know, maybe it has like.
Well, that would be called a scepter.
Not a scepter exactly. Although I could be like, I could act like I'm a queen. I could wear like a crown and carry a scepter,
right?
And then just use it to walk. But I was thinking more like a cool walking stick, like that has like a gargoyle on it, or something frightening. You know, something you could shake it at little kids and scare them away.
Right.
I don't know. I haven't figured out how I'm gonna.
How very Game of Thrones of you? Yes.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
A dragon.
Yeah, but he didn't say I needed a knee yet.
Well, that's good. Oh, you're still a young lady.
I am. That's what he said, and I gave him extra money for that.
Okay.
Yeah. Threw him a couple 20s for that. I said, thanks.
Wow.
I went last night to the, there was a soft launch for this new rideshare service that we wrote about called RideLinks.
Oh.
And
a new one.
Yeah. So I went over there. They had a little gathering at the Manchester Country Club, so I popped in there, and I'll probably write something further about it, because it's a great story, in that it's a local guy named Max. He came here from Pakistan when he was just 16. He's a Manchester guy, basically. You know, this was a big opportunity for his family. They were living pretty much in poverty and didn't have much of a life over there. But he's a go-getter. You know, he's a problem solver. And
thanks for joining us, Darryl.
I bumped into Crissy outside.
Oh, okay. But anyway, so that was cool. And
well, that sounds really cool. Sounds exciting.
It was cool. It's interesting, you know, that there's innovation all the time when you think, you know, how are you gonna beat Uber or Lyft or whatever. This is another. It's more like a limo service, but it's it caters to the driver and helps them to you know, because it's been such a disruptor, as we know.
Yeah.
Our friend Louis Applebaum has left the cab industry and has moved on to rideshare. And yet they say like Uber takes about 40% of
the market,
what you make on a ride.
Oh.
So this like if you pay, you know, $20 for your ride, Uber's getting most of that money, or a good bit more than they probably should. So you gotta do the ride hustle to make your money. But this app, because this guy Max comes from that industry, ran a limo service for a long time, he's created a way for the drivers to keep most of their money. He takes like 18%, and the driver can set their price. So it's a new option out there, and I guess you can do it all like a lot of the drivers do.
Very good.
You know, we're going to see so many changes in the next couple of years as technology continues to advance. You know,
it's advancing so rapidly. Jeez.
Fascinating to see.
It really is.
It is such a fascinating thing.
Fascinating.
Josh Groban. Wow. I don't know. Josh Groban.
Josh Groban.
I wonder if he's here right now in Manchester. Should we give him a call? Should we call over the hotel?
The show's not tomorrow. Till tomorrow, right, Carol?
He's probably not here then.
No. Show's tomorrow.
No,
might be someplace else tonight.
He might have a gig tonight.
Right, he probably does.
Yeah, and so I had so much to do yesterday. I did not get to go see Toy Story as planned, but I was happy to give my ticket to Nick LaValle. I can't wait to hear a report from Nick, but sounds like he was in auntie heaven, because he said, you know, most of the crowd was aunties, which he loves that.
Well,
that's his wheelhouse. You know,
yes.
He probably had a great time.
I'm sure he did.
I don't know if he liked the movie, but
he's Manchester's favorite uncle.
Yeah. So, but they keep selling those shows out. They added a couple more for the weekend. So if anybody wants to go see Toy Story 4, adult only, 21+, check out Chunky's. Go to their website or.
Well, you make it sound like it was an adult, like Toy Story, the adult version.
I know. That's what made me want to go, in a way, because it sounded so forbidding, you know?
Right.
Absolutely.
21+, adults only.
Well, Crissy is here now, Carol, so you can say hello.
Good morning, Carol.
Hello. Hi, Crissy. Yeah, I was even thinking, you know, could my sister and I get, like, you know, mani-pedis or something together?
Friday is a very, very busy day.
Well, you never know. You never know. We get cancellations and so forth. And I didn't look at the book. So if you, well, I can call you when I get in.
You could. Yeah. I mean, it was just a thought. But I mean, if I was gonna do that, it would only be to come to chill. It wouldn't be just in general. I wouldn't go someplace else. It would just be to say my sister, look at this cool place.
Thank you, Carol.
It's a cute little place over by Goldenrod.
Yes.
Yeah,
a stone's throw.
Then we should go to Goldenrod and get some food or ice cream or something.
Oh my God, everything's better with ice cream.
Yes, it
is. Did you know that it's Free Ice Cream Day on September 18th over at Goldenrod?
Your birthday. I'm definitely going.
Absolutely.
AARP.
I don't even eat ice cream, and I'm going.
And Peter's buying.
Yes, it's my birthday. That's right. Yes, exciting. Thank you, Carol. I appreciate that.
So, Carol, you're going to Josh tomorrow.
Yeah.
I I'm so excited. And just wait, you've got to be there and feel it. And I was listening to it earlier and I was like, oh my God, I'm so excited you're going, because it'll just change the way you feel about Josh.
Could you tell
I
how excited
Josh.
We were? Could you tell us, tell how excited Darryl and I were?
Sadly, I thought he was a comedian. I'm really sorry about that.
Oh my God, you've just got to, oh my God, he just raises you up, makes you feel amazing.
That's exactly what I figured was going to happen. So I didn't want to sound like I wasn't excited. It's just that.
You just haven't experienced him yet.
I haven't experienced him yet. And I was thinking about that too. Like back in the day, you know, we didn't have MTV yet. And so we did have albums and stuff. But the big thing was going to a concert to see a group. And then that would be like, they would then be your favorite group of all time. Because once you see anybody live, I mean, I can't think of anything I've ever seen live that I didn't love.
I totally agree. And you know what's funny? Because back in the 80s, I was all about Madonna and Whitney Houston and my little dance parties. But I went down to see Bruce Springsteen. I didn't even know his name.
Really?
Down in his hometown, because that's where part of my family's from, is Jersey.
Jersey, right.
And once I went to his concert, I just was like so in love. And all I could do was dance to Born in the USA. It was just unbelievable. You know, and I think about that American flag and Courtney Cox.
Courtney Cox.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
So
she
did the
dance in it. That's
well,
right.
That's when kind of right. Bruce Springsteen kind of, well, that really when he kind of launched. I mean, he was already big already, but
big time.
I mean, the Born in the USA thing was a big deal.
Oh, yeah.
And the Courtney Cox thing.
Yeah.
No, it's true. Anyway.
But yeah, anything live, really. Speaks
yeah, I
to
saw
our souls.
Back in.
I'm keep thinking about your Whitney Houston dance party.
Oh my God! Yeah.
Back in '65 at the JFK Coliseum live concert, Sam the Sham and the Pharaohs.
No kidding.
Yeah,
that's great.
Does
Who's
anybody
that?
Know who that?
I do. I know who it is.
Sam the Sham and the Pharaohs.
Uno, dos.
There it
one,
is.
One, two, tres, cuatro.
Woolly Woolly.
Whoa.
Pretty good.
Well,
no, it's good. Spicoli likes this song from Fast Times at Ridgemont High. All right, Carol. Sorry. Too much fun this morning.
Way too much.
No, it's okay. Yeah. That's how it should be on Friday.
No, and then we have a match game coming up, and you know what happens there.
All hell breaks loose.
Ellen Philbrook saw Josh about 5 years ago.
He's got a good voice. I'm not knocking the voice.
It's just, you thought he was a magician, you said.
No, a comedian.
Oh, a comedian.
You thought he was a magician.
Okay.
In his performance, and I saw him the first time at the Verizon Center, and I was just like blown away with his choir. Just, oh my God.
Very
it's
moving.
It's an experience.
Does he have backup singers?
Yeah, he did.
I would
I'm
imagine.
Assuming he does now.
I would imagine.
But he can, you know, he's like
soloist.
He can carry it, amazing.
Too, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Really. All right, Carol. Well, listen, we're going to move on. I hope you have a great time with your sister and a great time at the concert.
Yeah, me too. I'm excited.
You
I'm
sound
ready.
Very excited.
I might see you there.
You're going to?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
I know. I had to.
I don't even know where our seats are. My sister bought the ticket, so I don't really. But I'll once I get there, I'll text you.
Yeah, I'm in like 108 or something.
Okay.
Wow.
All right.
Yeah.
Everyone's going out.
Apparently, we're not going.
No.
You need to get tickets now.
No, we don't.
Are you going somewhere before or after?
Yes, I'm going with my girlfriend out to dinner at Crown.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh. I like it there.
Just, I do too. I'm really excited.
Yeah. If you can, eat outdoors, if it's nice enough to eat outdoors.
Yeah, she made a reservation, so hopefully, I think it's going to be sunny, right?
I think so.
Yeah, by tonight it should be.
Yep.
It
I heard
should
your
be.
Forecast that it was going to be a nice weekend.
Yes,
you guys.
That's my forecast for this morning, yes.
Meteorology challenged, yes. Meteorology.
It happens.
It's hard to say.
All right, Carol, listen, have a great weekend.
Have
Maybe
great
I'll run
time,
into you bro. Later today or sometime over the weekend. And if not, I will talk to you on Monday morning.
All right, then.
All right. Talk
bye,
to
Carol.
You soon, Carol.
All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
All right. Carol Robidoux, Manchester Inklink. You know what? I thought about that whole half hour. We were talking about Tom Petty. Like, what are the Heartbreakers doing now?
without Tom.
Right.
Maybe not much.
Probably not much. They've been around. They can retire.
I think so.
All right. Carol Robidoux, Manchester Ink Link, where everything in Manchester connects. You can find out what's going on around town at manchesterinklink.com.
The morning show is sponsored by CGI Business Solutions, located at 171 Londonderry Turnpike in Hooksett. They serve all your big and small business needs, employee benefits planning, corporate design and business administration, investments and wealth management, customized business insurance solutions. Their phone number is 866-841-4600. On the web at cgibusinesssolutions.com.
You're listening to Peter White. Call us at 250-6007. It's the morning show.
WMNH 95.3 FM. Good morning, Manchester.
All right, we are back here this morning. Good morning, Manchester. It's the morning show, and it's Friday morning. We're coming at you live in downtown Manchester from WMNH 95.3. How was your show last night, Darryl? The weekly Dion.
It was good. Yeah, we had a teacher from Memorial and the student that gave the valedictorian address.
Oh, okay.
It was great. It was great. Very good. You tell she was nervous.
Oh, really?
But it she was fine. Participated in the show. She was fine.
Do you remember the first day Crissy came in?
I was sweating so bad.
She was nervous.
Really?
Yeah, it's so
okay.
Nervous.
No, but it's okay.
You know, people can't. You can get nervous.
Oh, my God. Sure. Completely.
You know what it is? It's the unknown.
Yes, fear of the unknown.
Fear of the unknown. It scares the crap out of everybody.
Really? See, I like it.
Yeah. I don't care.
Yeah, I don't care either.
No.
All right, let's just go home.
Hey, we got to do the game, man.
Oh, I know. I know. So, Crissy, how was your week?
It's been a great week. It's been a whirlwind.
I thought that picture you put up of me was funny because she documented me getting my new talk. See, you know, this is what I've understood. I've learned a lot this week because there's so many. We all call it Botox. Botox is just a brand.
Right.
Like Band-Aid. You know what I mean? It's really a bandage.
Okay.
But you say Band-Aid. Give me a Band-Aid. Oh, right. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
It's a brand name. So, but this was technically I had the Nutox brand.
Yeah, the Nutox brand, which is Gervaux. And it is brand new, and it's performance beauty at its best. So it's not for headaches or any medical things, but it is a medical neurotoxin.
So it can be used for specific things.
Yeah, so it's specifically used for beauty.
Can't you tell?
Performance.
Absolutely.
I mean, can't you tell?
I mean, it's just wonderment.
Here's the thing, though, because what I learned about it is that once you get it injected, it takes a little while to, you know, whatever it does inside there.
Coagulate.
Like two weeks.
It does. It takes about a couple of weeks.
And I noticed in the past couple of days, you can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
You can feel it going on.
Let me see if you can raise your...
Yeah.
Can you squint a lot?
Yeah, I can. I'm just not doing it in front of you. I probably could. But I haven't been, though. You know, that's the thing. I've noticed myself not like, you know what I mean?
Not... So it's softening your face.
Oh, yeah.
You have such a soft face.
I know. I'm very sensitive,
no
Darryl.
Scowling.
No scowling. It's a permanent.
Even when you're mad, you don't look mad.
No, I have no emotion
That's
anymore.
Great. That's
no,
great.
You still do. It just softens things.
Right, yeah, it's good.
Right. So that's awesome that you guys are going to the concert as well.
Oh, yeah. I'm so excited. It was a random thing. I've been wanting to go. I went, you know, several years ago. And then all of a sudden, I heard his song, You Raise Me Up. And I was like, that's it. I was calling my girlfriend, and I'm like, do you want to go? And she's like, oh, my God, yes.
she likes him as
yes,
much as
yes, she does.
Do. Good,
yeah.
Good.
But I wasn't sure if she did.
Mm.
Maybe
you should get a ticket, Darryl. Sounds like you want to know all about it.
Not a chance.
Oh, it is amazing.
I'm sure it is.
Yeah.
Sure it is.
Why don't you don't want, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know what's pretty funny and super? It's about the kindness connection for me. And after I got my tickets, about 5 hours later, I got a random text from one of my girlfriends I haven't heard from in a while. You know, life is busy, and Lauren Gamache texted me.
Was it a text like, what up, girlfriend?
What's up, girlfriend? Actually, she's like, hey, what's up, beautiful? And she's so sweet. And so anyway, she reached out to me because we went to Josh Groban a long time ago. She's like, she had gotten her fiance, had gotten her tickets to Josh Groban. And she's like, you know what? We can't use them. So I would love to pass them on to you. And I was like, oh my God. Wow. She goes, you know what? I've loved his music since we've gone to the concert together and I want to do that. And I was like, oh my God, I just got tickets.
Wow.
But I have an idea if we donated them through Chill Cares. So we've been in search of two people. Well, because she has two tickets. And we're waiting to hear back from the patient advocate. But we do have someone in standby who is jumping for joy to have them.
Oh, I'll bet.
His
name is Darryl Dion.
Well, we wanted to do it with someone who's been involved with Chill Cares.
Right. That makes sense.
You know, and especially since the last minute, beautiful, kind gift. Oh, from Lauren Gamache.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really
so
nice.
Yeah, so it was just like so thoughtful.
Gonna make a couple of people very happy.
Right. Yes, exactly. It's about raising people up, you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Daryl's gonna be leaving us, you know, for a couple of
weeks. I know.
Take it easy with the leaving us part.
Right.
What are you gonna do, Peter?
Maybe we'll have because Tuesday will be his last, maybe we'll have kind of a semi hiatus party.
I like that. A hiatus party. All right, maybe I can come down.
Yeah, we can do it like, you know, we can play some funeral music and people can come on in and
it's just surgical procedure. Nothing.
A few nice things to say about you.
Or a few bad things to say about you, whatever the case may be.
Well,
yike.
I don't think there'd be too many people coming in to say bad things about you.
I hope not.
Right.
Try to live an exemplary life.
I know, and you do.
I'm trying.
Yeah, you're on the right path. Took you 70 years, but you're finally on the right path.
Ways to figure it out, man.
You're finally on the right path.
No, not 70. I think it's 50.
We are.
I love that.
We are glad to have you, Darryl.
Well, we're happy to have you, Darryl.
And I'm happy to be here.
Darryl, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, we're happy to have you, Darryl.
Oh, man. Boy. Oh, jeez.
So do you have any plans, Peter, without Darryl?
The show goes on. I haven't got to next Wednesday yet.
Yeah, no, I get it.
Yeah, so we'll see what goes down.
I'll keep you apprised.
I might have a few things up my sleeve.
I love the freestyle. That's what I do. Freestyle.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The freestyle.
Freestyling it.
Yeah, why not?
Because whatever happens.
Yeah, that's what I said. Like a lot of people say, "Well, what are you doing on the show?" I'm like, "Well, I have an outline of the show, right? Separated into four different parts. You know, the part one, two, three, four, mm-hmm. 2 hours.
Very good.
Each a half hour, Darryl.
Very good.
And but yeah, I have an outline, but I don't. You know, you got to go off the cuff.
It's organic.
Absolutely. It is.
Absolutely.
It's like Sam the Sham and the Pharaohs.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember the band that was with them. I can't. It might have been, I don't know. I don't want to guess.
Really?
I think it was the guy. Who was the band that sang Louie Louie?
That would be.
I think it was them.
The.
Exactly.
Yeah, the Kingsmen.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
See, and I just pulled that out. I didn't look it up or anything.
Unbelievable, really. And the place was packed. Bunch of whole lot. This is 65. So it was a whole maybe 64. But it was fun. It was definitely fun.
Wow. Very good. Sounds like a lot of fun, Darryl. We are going to miss you.
Yeah.
All right, let's
get
do this.
Get ready to match the star.
All right, here we go. It's our Friday morning. On the morning show, we have a match game Friday with Crissy Kantor from Chill Spa.
Good morning.
Darryl Dion.
Good morning.
And myself. This is all brought to you by Bill's Donuts, baked fresh daily. Stop in today for one of Bill's specialty donuts. That's right. You can get it at Bill's. Oh, yeah. I love that Bill's Donuts.
I love that the people are looking for them.
Well, it looks like we got someone on the phone. Good morning. You're on the air. Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning, Polly C.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hey, Polly.
Good morning, Crissy Kantor.
Good morning.
Wow, your voice sounds different.
Good morning, Peter. What?
There you go. That's more like it. That's more like it.
so manly.
Right. See, all Paul has to hear is the match game.
That's it.
And that's it. I thought it was Joe.
Glad to have you along, Darryl.
Good.
Now, have you heard Darryl will be leaving us?
Yeah, that pine box scenario. You know that one. Right. You know that one.
All right. So,
yeah.
So, Paul, you're ready to play, huh?
I'm ready to go.
All right. Chrissy's here from Chill Spa. We talked about that the other day, right?
Yes.
Yeah, when are you coming up, Polly?
I'm giving it some thought, Chrissy. I don't know if I'm going to take the Nutox or whatever that thing is called that Peter had injected inside. But,
it's the treatment.
I might, the treatment. But I will probably take advantage of pretty much everything else you have in that building except for that.
No problem. Hey, there's always something for someone.
You are missing out, man.
I think you'll love the detox thing.
Yeah.
Well, you know, you've mentioned, I mean, there's just, I've got to go in there just to check it out. Because every time you go in there, you mention, and Peter mentions that there's just like so much, it's like Disneyland of like care in there and treatment and.
It really is. It really is.
Taking care of yourself.
Because I normally would never, I've never done that, really, you know. And I told you, right? And then you started. Polly,
the place is amazing. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
I walk out of there with a smile every time. But you
can't
feel good.
Help it.
That's right.
The vibe. It's
the chill
vibe.
Right. I look 35 years old all of a sudden. You know what I mean?
Well, kind of.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to go check it out.
All right. Well, let me know.
All right.
I want to make sure I'm there.
I will, Chrissy. I'll definitely let you know.
Awesome.
All right. Can we get on with the game here?
Let's do it.
All right. All right. So you're playing, right, Paul?
Let's play for some cash and prizes here already. I got to get to work.
Welcome, Pauly C.
All right. Pauly C is still on the phone. All right. Get ready to get locked in, everybody. As soon as I find it. All right. You ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Well, we're happy to have you, Darryl. Good luck to you.
Good luck to you, Darryl.
Killing me.
All right. Here we go.
Did you hear about the car modeled after Dolly Parton? Comes with extra large blanks.
Did you guys hear that?
Did you hear about the car modeled after Dolly Parton? Comes with extra large blanks.
Oh, boy.
I believe there's only one answer.
I agree.
Really?
Really? I can't think of it.
Well,
what in a car would accommodate her? I mean, what?
Wait. Maybe I need to re-listen to it.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I actually drew a picture.
Did you hear about the car modeled after Dolly Parton? Comes with extra large blanks.
Is he saying car?
Car,
yes.
Extra large blanks.
The car has extra large blanks because it's modeled after Dolly Parton.
Dolly. Locked and loaded.
You're locked
modeled
in, Darryl?
Modeled after.
You locked in, Darryl?
Locked in.
I'm locked in. Are you locked in, Chrissy?
I'm locked in.
All right. Polly C, are you locked in?
I'm something. I'm not locked in.
Okay. All right. Well, what do you say, Paul? What do you think the answer is? Do you want me to play it again for you?
Yes, please.
Did you hear about the car modeled after Dolly Parton? Comes with extra large blanks.
The car comes with extra large what, Paul?
Headlights.
Okay, that's not a bad one. Not a bad one. I'm just adding to my picture.
I got
Darryl, what do you say?
Headlights.
Headlights, very good. Chrissy?
I said headlights.
Oh, my God.
And you inspired me, so I drew.
Right. I said headlights.
I want to see that.
I said headlights.
Terrific art.
Right. That's
terrific.
Not bad, right?
I love it.
Did miss a little.
No, that
was. It was a sweep. We all matched?
Yep.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, we
nice.
Are. Yeah.
Are those halogens?
Yes. Oh, my God.
LED.
Oh, man.
Some nice headlights.
Yeah, those are terrific headlights.
No,
high
right.
beams.
Yeah. Oh, boy. All right. Let's move on to the next question. Everyone can get themselves together.
All right.
Roberta the robot said,
I think my husband Robbie has a short circuit. Every time I touch his blank, the garage door opens.
Well, you see, that's just silly.
Right. Well, I'm erasing headlights and putting...
Perhaps another body part?
Gonna go to that Chuck Berry song that John Manning played back in the day.
Sounds good to me.
Right.
Locked in.
I'm locked in.
Chrissy?
Locked in. Oh. Sorry. Right.
No, that's okay. That's okay. Polly C, what do you say?
Can I hear it again?
Of course you can.
Roberta the robot said, I think my husband Robbie has a short circuit. Every time I touch his blank, the garage door opens.
All right, Paul. What do you say?
I have no idea. Every time I touch his...
Every time Robbie the robot, the wife of Robbie the robot touches his blank, the garage door opens.
His on button.
All right. His on button.
He played it safe.
All right, Darryl, did you say on button?
Ding-a-ling.
Ding-a-ling, okay. All right. What did you say, Chrissy?
I said nose.
Nose.
I thought about that.
I went with Darryl, and I said ding-a-ling. And I even, ding-a-ling.
We got a match.
All right. I'm surprised you didn't say ding-a-ling. I even gave you a hint, Polly.
A clue. You clued me in.
That was a great heads up.
I know.
I took advantage.
You want to do one more with us, Paul? We got to give other people a chance. All right. Is Brooklyn Mike? Where the hell has Brooklyn Mike been?
Hey, where's he been?
No kidding.
Not a word this week.
No.
Oh, I hope his kitties are all right.
Right.
Didn't he have a cat issue last week?
Maybe. Yeah. I don't know. Well, you're going to the Sergio Mendez concert with him.
Yes, we are.
Guys' night out.
Yes, it's going to be awesome.
When's that?
Sergio
October
Mendez.
19th?
Sergio Mendez, tickets for two.
Hmm.
It's going to be awesome. I grew up with that guy.
Right.
You know,
all right.
So
he lived next.
Home.
He lived next door.
All right. I close by.
Over by Mammoth Mills. All right.
No, that's a bachelor's ice cream.
Right. Okay. Polly C, you ready?
I'm ready.
Harry said, I think the bionic woman is made out of old refrigerator parts. Every time she opens her mouth, I see blank inside.
Daniel, that was a disgusting look on your face.
I gotta hear it again.
Yeah, I'm locked in, but go ahead.
Rick said...
Oh, no, that it?
Jim said, I must have been raised by dogs. I gotta... Harry said...
There it is.
I think the bionic woman is made out of old refrigerator parts. Every time she opens her mouth... I see blank inside.
I don't know.
I don't know.
You know, to put the bionic, talk about the bionic woman and her mouth is a little risque.
Right.
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
I'm not locked in.
Mine's a good answer. As they would say in Family Feud land. Good answer. Tony Petrello, good morning to you.
Ding-a-ling would not be a good answer for this.
right, but no. good old Chuck Berry.
Locked in.
You're locked in, Darryl?
Yes.
Chrissy, are you locked in?
Yes, I'm locked in.
All right, Paul, are you all set?
Yes.
All right, what do you say, Paul? Do you want to hear it again?
Yes.
All right, makes sense, right?
Right.
Harry said... I think the bionic woman is made out of old refrigerator parts. Every time she opens her mouth, I see blank inside.
Well, Paul, what do you
say? Richard Dawson always used to make Gene Rayburn do that because he thought he was brilliant. So I'm making you do that too. So.
That's okay.
Ice cube trays.
Ice cube trays in the bionic woman's mouth.
Right.
All right.
That's all I could think of.
I locked myself. I'm waiting. I'll go next. I locked myself in with hot dogs.
I got because that's a refrigerator part.
I got veggies. I got veggies.
Oh, it needs to be a part?
Yeah, a part.
Wait a second.
Harry said.
Oh, yeah.
Apparently. I think the bionic woman is made out of old refrigerator parts. Every time she opens her mouth, I see blank inside.
Yeah, so she's a refrigerator part. It's like, what's in your refrigerator? That's how I read it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's how I read it.
That's why
well.
I said hot dogs.
That's why I said veggies.
Chrissy, what did you say?
I said egg trays.
Egg trays. Do they still make those?
Yes, and I actually have one.
You do?
Yes, I do.
You put eggs in it?
Yes.
Okay. Very good.
To the count of 12.
I haven't seen those in years.
Well, it's an old refrigerator.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
Sadly, right. Yes.
It's the kind you don't play hide and seek in, Paul.
No.
Oh, definitely not.
They're like ice cube trays only.
Right. The old ice box.
Only round. Right.
All right.
Okay, fellas, I got to go. Chrissy, have a good day. I'll talk to you all later. Okay.
See you,
talk to you later. Bye.
See you
bye,
at the
Paul.
Spa, Paul.
All right.
All right. Adios.
At the spa.
All right.
You think he'll ever go?
Maybe. I don't know.
I think he'd get a kick out of it. Just going and checking it out.
I think anyone that's...
I thought it was great.
Oh, I agree. I think anyone that is skeptical about doing anything, especially if you're a dude.
Absolutely.
You know, don't be. It's fantastic up there. You're not going to want to leave.
And you want to go upstairs.
Well, that's what.
We're not talking about what's upstairs. You want to go up there. Don't ask why. You just want to.
Right, right. It's true.
Well, we need to make our date, you know, so you guys can all chill out in the chill zone.
No, oh, the chill zone.
So then everyone else can experience it too.
Right. Yes. On the radio.
But anyone is welcome to come in for a tour anytime.
Oh, okay. That's great.
Yeah.
I think it'd be, you know, it's awesome.
All right. Phone lines are open. 250-6007. Facebook Live. Tony Petrello's in there. Good morning. Good morning to Angela Philbrook, Miriam Banish, Caitlin Plumpton. Good morning to you. Jay Page. A very good morning to you. And, Ed Murphy's still sitting in there. So, good morning. All right. You guys ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Jim said, I must have been raised by dogs. I get a very strange urge every time I see a blank.
Raised by dogs. Well, seems pretty easy. All right, I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Are you locked in? You need to hear.
Is it asking what exactly? What the strange urge is?
Jim said.
I'm confused.
I must have been raised
well.
By dogs. I get a very strange urge every time I see a blank.
Well, what's that urge?
Right, a strange urge. Hmm. It could be anything. Could be.
Yeah, okay, I'm locked in.
You're locked in. All right. What do you say, Darryl?
Bone.
Bone. The big bone.
The urge to bury the bone.
Right. Bury. All right. Chrissy, what did you say?
I said pee on a tree.
Oh, okay, because I just...
You know, that makes a lot of sense.
Right, I said fire hydrant.
There you go. That's a match.
An urge to be on a fire hydrant, I guess.
Okay.
Your big bone, though. That was the best answer.
They are right.
Rick said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I broke a tooth on the blank.
Hmm.
So many ways to go.
Right. I'm not locked in. Oh, my God. I need to hear it again.
Rick said, Rick. My wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I broke a tooth on the blank.
Okay. I'm going to say...
locked in.
You are locked in?
Yes.
Okay. I am locked in. What do you say? Chrissy, locked in?
I'm locked in.
All right.
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
I said Cobb.
Cobb. Okay. I said mashed potatoes. I'm hungry.
Wow.
I'm hungry. All right.
That was no bad.
Harry said, I am never going back to that rotten bar. I asked the bartender for a stiff drink, and he brought me a glass full of blank. Harry said, I am never going back to that rotten bar. I asked the bartender for a stiff drink, and he brought me a glass full of blank.
fucking class full of, oh, boy. This might be the last day of this show. okay. I'm locked in, everybody. Locked in.
Me too.
That's right.
Locked in.
All right. Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Harry said, I am never going back to that rotten bar. I asked the bartender for a stiff drink, and he brought me a glass full of blank.
Let's go to Darryl Dion from Manchester.
Glass, glass full of ice.
Glass full of ice. All right. It's okay. Chrissy, what did you say?
Okay. Ice.
Oh, damn.
Wow. I would have never guessed we had a match on that one.
I know, me too.
I'm surprised you guys didn't match me. I said ding-a-lings. Yeah.
I thought you were going to say that.
I am never going.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, that's enough.
Enough with the ding. I've over. Okay.
Have you heard about the new movie about a frog? No. Well, I'll tell you about it. It's called Deep Blank.
That's right, Darryl.
Oh, God. What the heck?
Whoa. Okay.
All right. You ever see that movie, Dale?
Yes, I have.
I have not.
It was just on again.
Wait a second. Are we talking about the same movie?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And we don't even have to say it.
Okay, no. We don't.
Oh, we need to hear this again.
Okay.
Have you heard about the new movie about a frog? No. Well, I'll tell you about it. It's called Deep Blank.
All right, Darryl. I'm locked in also. Chrissy? Are you locked in?
I suppose.
All right, Darryl.
I went as deep as I could.
Right.
Throat.
Deep throat. But it's a frog.
Deep throat.
Okay. Okay. Whoa. All right, let's go to Chrissy.
I said throat.
See, I got it. Okay, guys, this is what it was.
Have you heard about the new movie about a frog?
A frog.
No, yeah. Well, I'll tell you about it. It's called Deep Blank.
I said Deep Croak. That was the whole thing.
You know,
admit it.
You're right. You're right.
But when they blow
you ever
up
saw
their
that movie?
Necks.
When you said deep, there was only one answer. I mean, right.
Right. That's right.
And primarily because it was replayed recently on HBO, whatever.
Are not you sure they played that on HBO?
Oh, sure, sure, sure. It's not as vulgar as you might think it
whoa,
is.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Yes, it is.
Wow.
No, there's a. I mean, and you may have seen the edited version, but.
Maybe.
Oh, yeah. They don't play that on HBO. Let me just say. Maybe they don't even play it on Cinemax after dark. I think you have to order that on the internet or something, Darryl.
I don't know. I think
maybe you should watch it again.
I think I may have to.
Well, I don't think you guys should. Let's be appropriate.
Probably not.
That's right. All right, let's move on.
Please. Linda Lovelace. I was trying to think of her name.
Yeah.
My bad.
Oh, what happened here?
Yeah.
My bad.
Are you telling me it?
Larry said, my wife must be having an affair with an insurance salesman. I just found a piece of the rock in my blank.
Okay, well, wow. A piece of the rock. Yeah. These are tough today.
Ooh.
I don't even kind of get it.
Well, because they say the insurance, the piece of the rock, Prudential, the piece of the rock. You know, that's...
Can we hear it again, please?
You can hear it again. Let me see if I can...
Denny said...
Nope.
Larry said, my wife must be having an affair with an insurance salesman. I just found a piece of the rock in my blank.
So, yeah, I'm going to just say, all right, I guess. Well, it makes sense. I'm locked in. I am locked in.
I'm flatlined.
Yeah.
All right. We're not talking about that movie anymore.
Absolutely not.
All right.
Locked in.
All right. I'm locked in too, Chrissy?
No.
You're not locked in yet.
No.
All right.
Don't even kind of get it.
Okay. You're passing.
Sorry,
on this one?
I'm passing.
That's okay. That's okay. Chrissy has passed. I said bed.
I said shorts.
Shorts. A piece of the rock in his shorts.
That's gonna be painful, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I think Chuck Berry was saying about that back in the day. Let's take a quick little break. We'll be back.
You're listening to Peter White. Call us at 250-6007. It's the morning show.
It's morning in Manchester on WMNH.
Hey, it's Friday morning, everyone. Good morning, Manchester. We are back here. Start off your weekend the right way. We got some overcast skies right now, but that should be breaking up later on today to set up for a great weekend. It's
supposed to be awesome.
Yeah. All right, we're in the middle of Match Game Friday here. We have Chrissy Kantor from Chill Spa. Good morning, Chrissy. Oh, sorry. Let me get you. Good morning, Chrissy.
Oh, good morning, guys. Are you blocking me, Peter?
No, I'm not blocking.
I thought you only did that with Eazy-G.
No, I know. No, I don't. But, Darryl, good morning.
Good
Darryl, morning. You'll be leaving us in a...
Just a hiatus.
It's just a hiatus.
Exactly.
That's
like
right.
That.
It may only be a few weeks.
That's right. Let's get back to the game.
All right.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Henrietta is such a hypochondriac.
Yep, that's it.
That's it.
Boy, I really messed up.
Henrietta is such a hypochondriac.
All right. Well.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's it. I've ruined the show again. Second day in a row.
Well, good news. Only you can do it.
Right. But I'll tell you what. I could pull out some. Let me see what we got here. All right. Are you ready?
Ready.
Harvey said, yeah, Harvey said my blind date last night was really masculine. When I went to pick her up, she wasn't quite ready. She was blanking.
Oh. All right. I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Wow, you are.
What? I'm like flatlining today.
Really?
Can I listen to that again?
Well, of course you can.
Absolutely.
Of course you can.
Harvey said, yeah, Harvey said my blind date last night was really masculine. When I went to pick her up, she wasn't quite ready. She was blanking.
She was very masculine.
Very masculine.
Very masculine. She wasn't ready for the date because she was blanking. What do you say, Darryl?
Shaving.
Shaving.
Shaving? Oh, picking masculine. Her. I'm thinking of actually picking her up.
Oh.
No, no, no.
Not. Picking her up on the date.
Picking her up on a date.
Oh, got it. Yeah, she was definitely shaving.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I said shaving also. Shaving.
Yeah, you just got misconstrued.
Yeah.
As a lot of things do here.
From time to time. Right. Yes, yes.
Deep croak.
Danny said to the devil, he said, I've been all around. Down here ain't so bad. In fact, compared to blank, this is heaven. Danny said to the devil, he said, I've been all around. Down here ain't so bad. In fact, compared to blank, this is heaven.
Oh.
I'm not getting that one at all.
You're not getting this one?
I mean, the guy's in hell.
The guy.
Danny said to the devil, he said, I've been all around. Down here ain't so bad. In fact, compared to blank, this is heaven.
So okay. Compared to another place.
I got it.
Okay.
I got it. I just figured it out. I'm running out of ink here.
Okay. All right. I'm locked in. I'm locked in. Are you locked in, Chrissy?
Can I hear it again? Can I hear it again, please?
Yeah, I guess so.
You want to hear it again, Darryl?
Please.
Of course.
Danny said to the devil, he said, I've been all around. Down here ain't so bad. In fact, compared to blank, this is heaven.
I don't really have an answer.
I just thought of it.
You did?
Yeah.
Really?
One, as it turns out, there's only one answer.
Oh, see, I'm gonna
Oh my God. Tony, I'm gonna flatline again.
Tony Petrello said Manchester. Come on now, Tony.
Not nice.
Right.
Locked in.
You're locked in. We don't even have an answer. So go
I don't
ahead.
Have an
what
answer.
Is your what is
yeah,
your
what
answer?
Is your one answer?
Yeah.
It's gotta be purgatory.
Purgatory. First thing you think of, right, Darryl?
Between hell and heaven is purgatory, where you're hanging out for God knows how
long. Yeah, it's called real life.
Yeah.
Reality. All right.
So we're all in purgatory. You know, you don't hear much about that anymore.
Well, right, because you don't?
No.
No?
You know, maybe that's... Growing up being Catholic, you'd hear it about it all the time.
Right.
You know, if you got a ton of venial sins, you're going to have to spend some quality time in purgatory.
Hmm. Yeah, where you have to work hard, right?
Yeah, somehow. Why?
Well, what the hell do you think we're doing here while we're on Earth?
I think we're working hard.
I think we're working real hard.
Okay, we have another question here.
Fred said, I don't think my new marriage is going to last. On our wedding night, my wife stopped everything to make a phone call to her blank.
Oh, boy.
Locked in.
I'm also locked in.
Locked in this time.
All right. We are locked in here. Everybody is locked in.
Gotten it together.
I think so. I think we're coming around, Darryl. And by the way, let me wish you a... All right. What do you say? What do you say?
Therapist.
Oh, a therapist. Okay. Chrissy, what do you say?
I said mother.
Oh, I said boyfriend.
Whoa.
Ooh.
Well, marriage isn't going too good.
Not well
at
all.
Have to call her boyfriend.
Yike.
Oy.
I know. Okay. All right. What are you doing? So you're going to the concert. You got a big week planned?
Yeah. I actually, we're going to see Toy Story 4 tonight and celebrating Dante's and Violet's birthday.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Fantastic. She just graduated from high school.
Where's it being played, Toy Story?
We're going to Chunky's.
Oh, okay. You know, yeah. In town, right?
In town.
You know, that is so nice. Samantha lives just a stone's throw away from there now. She loves it.
Oh, it's fantastic.
You go there, you sit down in a comfortable chair, have some decent food, right? Is the food decent?
Yeah.
Well, if you know.
I've had their nachos and I like them.
It's not gourmet food, but you know.
It's not American Chop Suey.
I need to know if they have that on the menu.
American Chop Suey?
American Chop Suey.
I'll look it up.
Oh, jeez.
All right.
But my favorite is Regal 8.
I like that one, too.
That's my all-time favorite.
Exit 10?
Yeah.
Exit 10.
Because I lived up there for a long time, and I remember when they changed over and they got those seats. It's fantastic. You can actually, it's almost, you got to be careful. You can, like, fall asleep. It's not as good as the chairs at the Chill.
But, thank you.
Now, the chairs at Chill, are they chairs from automobiles?
No, they're specific pedicure chairs, they're massaging, and they massage you everywhere.
Yikes.
They do.
It sounds really too good.
It's really too good. you don't want to get out.
Right, exactly.
Usually if it goes off, I restart it. I start it up and go another round.
Good
twice.
Job. Absolutely.
Right, I do it twice.
It's going to be pretty crowded, I'll bet, too.
All right, let's...
I think so.
I would think so.
Just don't lay on your stomach, Darryl.
No,
the president of El Cheapo Airline said, we just taught an ape to fly our airplanes. The only problem is, at the end of the flight, the cockpit is full of blank.
Oh, this is an easy one. This is just an easy one. Locked in. So locked in.
Locked in.
All right. I'm just going to go. Are you locked in?
I'm locked in.
I'm going to go first this time. I said banana peels.
Banana peels.
Oh, I just said bananas.
Well, that's all right. That's all right.
No, we can examine this a little closer.
Okay, let's do it, Darryl.
Do apes, monkeys, gorilla, do they eat the peel? Do they consume it in its entirety?
You don't think they peel it like us?
Oh, I know they don't peel it.
Well, you have.
Can you imagine watching a monkey peeling a banana?
It just but it would get so messy, though. Seems like it would get messy. They just squeeze it?
I don't know about the squeezing part.
Are you looking it up?
I'm going to look it up.
Well, you don't have to.
I am.
All right, let's do this one here. Are you ready, Darryl?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. I don't know. I got to find one. I'm on old ones now.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah.
The marriage counselor said to Ralph, when I told you and your wife to smooth things out, I didn't mean that you should use a blank on her.
All right. I'm locked in. I'm going to call a super lock.
Super. Can I hear it again, please?
You sure can.
Thank you.
The marriage counselor said to Ralph, "When I told you and your wife to smooth things out, I didn't mean that you should use a blank on her."
All right. You need more time, Darryl.
No, I can't think of the word I want to say.
Jeez. Really? Let's say a very good morning to our friend Gary Tibbetts, who's starting, you know, he's been, you know, recovering from his surgery, but you notice he's sleeping later each morning?
Later and later.
Yeah, thanks for joining us at the end of the show, Gary. We could have used you at 7.
Yeah, good really. Good morning, Peter.
Yeah.
Your wife was up way before you. Darryl, you need to hear it again?
One more time.
I lost it. Never mind. I really did because I played that.
That's okay.
Good morning, Peter.
Good morning.
All right, we're going to do one more of these match games, and then we're going to wind down. And we're going to go through a wind down for the end of the show.
Okay.
And Crissy will give us some good advice on how to, whatever she says.
Peel a banana.
Yeah. There you go. All right. Let's see. Are you ready, Darryl?
Yeah. Ready. Locked in.
You're locked in. Now, this will be your last match game for a while because, as you know, you'll be leaving Tuesday.
I'm leaving on a jet plane.
Right. Yeah. On your hiatus.
Yeah.
Ugly Ed is really ugly. When he was a baby, his mother put a label on him so she would know which end to blame.
What?
That's from last week.
I thought we didn't do our answer yet.
Yeah, we didn't do the answer to the other one.
I know, but I lost the question.
Oh, you lost it. Oh, okay.
Oh, I thought that was a good one, though.
What did you say?
I said iron.
Yes.
Oh, that is a good
smooth things over.
Exactly.
Oh, you know what I...
Iron him?
Yeah, you know what I said? I said steamroller.
Oh, there you go. Same thing.
Well, I had the general idea, but I couldn't think of the name. You know, the smooth over cement and spackle or whatever.
Really?
Drywall?
Yeah, that works.
Drywall is face.
Right. Okay, good. We got over that one. Good, because I lost track.
Good.
Ken said, "How can anybody say all people are created equal? I just saw blank standing next to Dolly Parton."
Oh, boy.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah.
Ken said,
"Please.
How can anybody say all people are created equal? I just saw blank standing next to Dolly Parton."
So it would be like some skinnier, someone not the big headlights, like
got it.
Right.
Okay. Got it. Thank you for that. I needed it.
Right.
Now I got an answer.
You do. Yeah. Cause it would have
turns out it's easy.
Yeah.
It's easy.
It's definitely for the time too.
Yes.
When the match game was out. But go ahead, Crissy, are you locked in?
I'm locked in.
All right. What did you say?
I said Twiggy.
All right, let's go over to Darryl.
Twiggy.
All right, Peter White said Twiggy. All right.
Wow.
That was great.
That's a full.
There's only one answer, though.
What else would it be?
What it is.
Yeah, what else would it be, right?
I couldn't think of that, really. And she was a very popular
supermodel.
Supermodel.
Oh, yeah,
exactly.
Way back. Exactly. Way back in, like, late 60s?
We're aging ourselves.
Disturbingly so, yes. I think it was late 60s.
Oh, okay.
In the 70s, the mod thing, you know, in England and stuff.
Yeah.
She was extremely skinny.
Really? Hmm. So there have been a lot of supermodels over the years. Right? Right?
I
don't know. Now, you've been to fashion shows, Crissy.
Yes.
You've been to runway shows?
Not like the big time ones.
Right. Not yet, anyway.
Yeah, not. Oh, I love that.
There you go. Yeah, see?
There's always that possibility.
Right.
You know, it's funny, guys. I was watching the Kardashians, and I barely ever watch it. And all of a sudden, I see Kim Kardashian. She's on and with the medical medium that I've been talking about. And so she has, I think, psoriasis. I only saw a little segment. But he had said, you need celery juice, and it's going to detoxify your liver. And so I was like, oh, my God, that's, you know, unbelievable.
You're not the only one drinking it.
Right.
For sure.
But the thing is,
there is a celery shortage.
That's it.
Not very likely.
And a few minutes later, she's like, well, it didn't work. And so my question is, how long did she really take the celery juice? Right. Because sometimes you just give up because she's like, well, I didn't really like the taste. And I was like, well, you know,
you gotta push
if it's
through
going
that.
To cure you and help you, You know, you got to commit. And sometimes you have to do things for a while to see the results. So my question is, Kim, how long did you drink the celery juice?
She may have only consumed it one, maybe even 2 days. And that's not nearly enough
exactly.
for it to start.
No, you have to keep
gaining the benefits.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because there's so many posts that he does on his Instagram that reposts of people transforming skin conditions, depression, anxiety, so many different things.
You must have went crazy when you heard about the celery juice.
Yeah. I was like, oh my God, that's well, first of all, I'm like a super fan of his. Just, yeah.
He's
just amazing. A super fan. Because he's just, you know, helping people, you know.
You're talking
it's
about
taking the anxiety, the medical
about,
medium.
Oh, okay. I didn't know. I didn't know if you're talking about the medical medium or Kanye West.
Oh no! But I did see Kanye on the Letterman show on Netflix, and it was interesting how he's explaining the bipolar.
Okay.
And yeah.
He suffers from that.
Yes.
Okay.
You ever check that out? Letterman has a interview show,
and he's got a really huge beard.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Whoa.
He was just on one of the...
Almost unrecognizable. Almost.
Yeah, but you know what? I think he misses it.
Oh, I know he misses it.
Right.
He didn't go away long. Didn't he get a show right away?
Yeah, but it's on his own terms. Right. And he probably goes and records a bunch of those and just, you know.
You're right.
Because I guess he lives in Montana. Him and his...
Hence the beard.
Right. they have a place out in Montana. They
must
still have their place in Connecticut. Yeah, but they ride horses and... David Letterman.
He's now mounting horses.
One of the greats, though.
Oh, yeah.
Letterman. I agree. Okay, back to the medium thing. We always get sidetracked here.
Oh, well, just talking about the benefits of celery juice. Exactly. And it's not just a one-hit wonder. You know?
Now, is this just a new discovery? It seems like celery must have been around for many, many years. And now people are just doing that now?
Or
has it always been something?
They found the advantages to doing it through science.
I think
so. And that takes time. Science isn't like, it just pops out of a shell.
Right.
It takes, work, scientific procedures.
A lot of research, Darryl.
Tons.
Trial and error.
Absolutely.
Right.
And then sharing good information.
Right. Getting it out.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
You can't deny before and afters in people's personal experiences with the healing.
Right.
Next week, we'll take some after shots when this is all set up in because I know, believe it or not, Darryl, she put the picture up on Facebook. There was a faction of people, maybe two, that said, we want some after pictures of Peter White. And I was like, oh, my God. I almost was going to send him some. And then I'm like, wow, wait, hold on a second.
We want to show the before and the after.
Right. But I'll let you do it so we get the right lighting and we get the,
Well, it's all about keeping the lighting consistent so that you have true before and after pictures.
Did you do it before?
Yes, we did.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Jen did.
Oh, this is great. This is great. She'll be able to make that comparison in, 3 months?
Well, really, next week?
Next week.
Friday, next Friday, it'll be two weeks. And that's the target date.
Oh, okay.
You might not even recognize. Oh, you won't recognize me because you're leaving.
I got a TV.
Aww.
I'll see you on TV.
And then I think we're off for a week. Is that the 4th of July week after next week? Or is it two?
I think so. Yeah. God. Today's
is that
the,
already?
The holidays are
today,
here.
What's it today? The 21st?
Yeah. Oh, no. Maybe we have 2 weeks to go.
21st? 2 weeks.
I'm like,
it's 2 weeks.
Let me next look at the calendar.
Yeah, look at the calendar. I'm all messed up.
Goodness. No, it's 2 weeks away is the 4th of July minus one day.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Wow.
Wow. Ben's off that week as well.
Yeah. We take that week off every year. So
a great week to take off.
It is. I think the weeks we take off at the show here, we take the week between Christmas and New Year's.
Mm-hmm.
We take 4th of July, sometimes even that last week of summer.
Didn't you take April vacation off?
Yes.
I did. That was the first time.
Yeah, you went to Florida.
Yeah, that was the first time I did that. But I figured,
Would you do it again?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Why not?
You deserve to chill too, Peter.
I know. Do I, though? Do I really deserve it?
Yeah, everyone does.
Absolutely.
We need to be kinder to ourselves.
Typically, Fridays are pretty busy up there.
Yeah, we're pretty busy.
Getting ready for the weekend and all that stuff.
Yes. Lots of spray tans, pedicures.
Spray tans are great. Yeah. I'm a fan of the spray tan. I'm a fan of the new tox.
Well, I think I could become a fan of the tan. Fan of the tan.
Oh, you would.
Because my perception of it was orange, and it's not.
Yeah, we do not do orange.
No.
There is no shade of orange at Chill Spa.
No, if you come out orange, that's on you, man.
Yeah. Yeah. Or you're putting on the wrong products after, you know, you're using some of the self tanners.
Typically, it's just a tan.
It's a tan. You look tan.
Oh, yeah.
You look tan.
Yeah, you have to do all the right things, though. You have to do this, and then you do this, and then you actually got to do some funny poses. And I did it in my underwear in front of a complete stranger.
Chrissy, did we get pictures of that?
No, absolutely not.
No, there's none of that going on. But
good.
But it was really like, what was her name that did that?
Amanda.
Amanda did a great job. I was her, like, other than the girls that worked there and stuff, I was the... her real first client.
Really?
Yes.
Yes.
And she done good.
Yeah, she did a great job.
Yeah. She did a really good job.
You still look a little tan.
That's just regular now.
Well, it's nice to feel good on the beach and just feel good in your skin.
Oh, yeah. I didn't wear a shirt for like 2 weeks. Right. You know what I mean? I was like,
Yeah, you don't want to be that white guy hitting the beach.
Yeah, that can be. I've been there before, but that's not good because you get sunburned.
Exactly.
Yeah. SPF all the way. That's the most important thing for your health and for anti-aging. Is the number one thing is to wear sunscreen.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I for sure need the anti-aging stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you think though? I don't know. You know
I think
what?
You look great, Darryl.
Right.
You do not look 70.
I don't feel 70.
No,
that's the best part of the story.
Well, yeah.
You know, I feel, you know.
You feel great.
50.
You feel
I love it.
Wow.
You know, it's difficult to assess how I feel because I haven't felt this way in so many decades.
Right.
Like literally decades.
You feel good.
I feel good. Da, da, da,
da, da, and why is that?
I lost I lost some serious insulation.
Yeah.
We'll just use that.
Yeah.
And, I've always had positive, vibe all the time.
Yeah.
And I tried to pass that on to my kids, and they're also very positive people.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been quite a journey.
It's what it's about, though, being positive.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Couldn't have done it without the positivity.
Right.
You know?
No, I hear you.
And lifting each other up and helping each other along the way.
Absolutely.
Which is so key.
It is key. It's key for all of us and everybody out there.
Yeah. And about being kind to ourselves and not judging ourselves so much, you know? I think that's what I love about the spray tan, and that's what really started us in the business of putting our name out there as the spray tan, because it is instant gratification. You do feel good when you're tan. It camouflages cellulite, your veins. It just makes you feel so much better. So the things that we harp on are for ourselves, and it's aging, and we all have our little imperfections. So I always say, I'm perfectly imperfect.
Exactly.
You know? And we need to be kinder to ourselves, but doing those nice other kind things help us feel better.
That's true.
Oh yeah.
You know? And then when we feel better, we are kinder to each other.
Well, we're kinder to each other. It's better for your own health, your internal health,
actually,
your whole well-being.
Trickle down theory.
It totally is.
You know,
that's some great advice, Chrissy, on a Friday. That's always nice.
Thank
very
you.
Always very positive. On social media, I realized on Father's Day, you put some pictures out there and. There was, I think, one out there of you as a little girl.
Yeah.
And I was like, I had never seen. I'm like, aw.
Thank you.
A little. And then, I, of course, I'm looking at the other pictures. And then there was a period of time Chrissy's hair was short.
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And I've been wondering, should I cut it off again, you know?
You think about that?
I do. I think about that. And I was like, because I am going to be 50. And if I do cut it off, am I ever going to grow it back?
Right.
Because I've cut my hair, went from really, really long hair to a pixie cut, like Twiggy, when I was 22.
Right.
And then I
did you like it?
I did. I love it. I loved it. And then I grew it out again. And then around 27, I cut it off again. Went really short.
Yeah.
And then I grew it out again. And so I'm like, once I cut it, I don't know if I'll like. Because I do. I love stylish short hair.
Right, right.
So I'm like,
Look at Darryl. Stylish.
Yeah.
Short hair.
Thanks to Chrissy.
That's
Thank
right.
You.
Wow, you know, look at this.
Yeah,
I actually need a haircut soon.
You
so
do.
Maybe
we need to book you.
Yes, maybe next week sometime before the holidays.
Yes.
You know, I thought it's funny because my hair is really getting long, longer than it's been in a while, and if I play with it a little bit, I put some cool sunglasses on, I look pretty good. Like I'm like I think I'm pulling it off.
You're like, oh, I'm smoking.
Right. I was like, whoa.
So when's the last time you had short hair? Has it been a long time?
It's probably been like maybe, I probably had shoulder length about 8 years ago or something, I think.
Okay.
So that's been a while. So
it's been a while.
So to wrap your brain around the short hair theory.
Yeah.
That's going to be tough.
Yeah, because I'm like, once I go short, I don't know if I'll grow it out again. So,
and you don't
know
if you'll actually like it short.
Oh, yeah, I know. So I look, I don't know. I did love it when it was short.
Well, Stefan Philbrick says he loved your short early 90s cut.
Oh, thanks, Stefan. So much fun.
All right, we're going to say goodbye to our Facebook Live room.